Here's an idea. We are gonna try to explain why people don't like internet memes.
Let's see how this goes. So I'm guessing that when we show an image like this, or when I say over 9,000, a collective groan can be heard from space, or at the very least from Hoboken.
Hoboken, no joking, what?
Even I occasionally wince at Idea Channel's use of all the things, or Zoidberg, or Spider-Man. The quick and sometimes nearly instant aging process of image macros, snow clones, and videos born of the internet has become one of their central features. Old internet humor is a special kind of cringy, humorless pain. And sure, all humor has a half-life, 3 confirmed. But as far as some corners of the internet are concerned, the use of old internet memes,
and sometimes internet memes in general at all, is unforgivable. The comedic transgression enacted by the earnest use of a Willy Wonka macro is less like telling a knock-knock joke and more like continuing to quote Borat. My life, the obvious and probably most correct explanation of why is the sheer volume of internet humor that most of us see. Well, we all eventually got sick of yo mama jokes and oh, righty then. It took people only a couple months to tire of Doge. It took the Harlem Shake about a week and... and familiarity with funny pictures plus text and weird videos has grown, so too has the speed and volume of their production. It's just a thing that so many of us do now. By comparison, classically overtold joke cycles like blonde, knock-knock, or viola jokes seem downright rare, which is probably why you might wince at the punchline, but the form itself doesn't aggravate the way a yo-dog might. You could even be proud to know a good example of an old joke cycle. So, a violist and a cellist are standing on a sinking ship, and the cellist falls into the water and says, "Help, I can't swim!" And the violist goes, "Don't worry, just fake it!" But even with a good yo-dog that's creative or clever or novel or whatever, you see exhibit face and your brain just says no. And no, enough, I've seen enough. Whatever you heard, friend, you heard wrong. But I don't think the aversion begins and ends with ubiquity. Arguably, we're overexposed to all kinds of things that don't age as poorly and, ironically, as quickly as YOLO. Maybe their age has something to do with it. I mean, the internet meme itself is, as far as we know, is an awkward cultural adolescence having been new and cool only 5 or 6 years ago, when YouTube was only 3 years old and Twitter and Tumblr were just born. As a quick side note, as far as I know, my mom was the first person to refer to anything as an internet meme, and he did that in Wired in 1993, so the idea stuck around for much longer than that. Or maybe it's that we put our faces at the internet all day, every day, because of work, community, entertainment, education, necessity, habit, and it's just a fear, especially with something that you've had enough of, like it is invading your internet. There's a tendency, especially online, to feel like the stuff itself is wasting our time by being in front of our eyeballs. We experience a mental and visual exhaustion having to see another Armageddon. At some point, if you're not even seeing it anymore, you're just being subjected to it. It's kind of like if my wife replaced your ringtone, car horn, or her ringmate with a timer, which also provides context for people who, say, watch a YouTube video and then immediately comment something like, "That was the worst 10 minutes of my life." My life, here's a complicated compulsion to consume that is reinforced by tons of online platforms. People talk about it on Reddit or BuzzFeed, endlessly scrolling through Tumblr, binging on YouTube, or reflecting reading, refreshing over images for hours at a time. These are the places that you go for entertainment or social interaction that gives you a creative outlet or from which you derive a sense of community or purpose. And the idea that you are fully choosing to view 100% of the media that pops up on your screen becomes a little more complicated. Lots of online spaces function like public spaces, right? We don't exactly choose to see everything you do out on the street, right? Reddit exists through Tumblr, pages, Tumblr, 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 Tumblr,
I'm
Internet.